Hi, everybody. Laura here for Pretty Pink Posh. Thank you so much for joining me today. I've got a couple of fun Mother's Day projects to share with you featuring the Spring Flowers stencil set. And I'm going to show you two different ways to use this set to get two different looks. Okay, so for the first card, I have a panel of Nina Solar White cardstock, adhering it down to my grid mat with some masking tape. The first stencil that I'm using is the leaves stencil. So one stencil is all leaves, and the other stencil is all blooms. So you could take one green ink and go over this whole stencil and it would be beautiful. I chose three different shades of green to spice it up. I have distress inks and twisted citron, crushed olive, and mowed lawn. And I am using three different blender brushes because I like my twisted citron to stay twisted. And normally I don't care too much, but for this particular, I wanted to get three different distinct shades of green. I have cleaned my blender brushes in a pinch. When you don't have enough, you can clean it and use it on a lot of different colors. But you know, let's face it, you're gonna need a few blender brushes. It's nice to have a lot of different ones to use for a lot of different colors so that your colors can stay true. Okay, on my last one, you lift it up and bada boom, you got a nice leafy background. Okay, I'm gonna lay on the second stencil, which is the blooms, and you kind of just line it up so that the blooms rest on top of the stem. And I have some warm tones for the blooms. I have Kitsch Flamingo, Picked Raspberry, Candied Apple, Carved Pumpkin, and then a little mustard seed for the yellow. It's kind of a Mother's Day rainbow happening here with the blooms. So again, I did want to mention too, people always ask, I'm using the ink stand for my distress inks and they just kind of hold it steady. Brianne Loveland sells these in her Etsy shop and they are handy dandy to hold your ink cubes when you're blending. And then you have this beautiful floral background. Now for the sentiment, I'm going to use the Mom Mother script dies. Just using the mom right now on this card. And I did one out of gold foil and three out of white. I'm going to stack these up to make it nice and dimensional. I'm using some Barely Arts glue, which is my latest obsession. It has not clogged on me. It's got a precision needle tip end on it. And that gold foil really makes it nice and fancy schmancy for mom. And mom deserves it. Okay, not that you got to do this, but every once and again, I like to flick it up. So I smushed the crushed olive onto an acrylic block. I took up a wet brush and just flicked on a little crushed olive onto the background. Gives it a nice texture. Now I'm stamping a coordinating sentiment from the Mom stamp set. It says, "Thanks for all you do." Couldn't be a more fitting sentiment for a mom card, am I right? Now I'm gonna pop up this floral panel onto a cream card base and then put a little glue on the back of my mom word die. To finish it off, I'm gonna add a few of these Pretty Pink Posh jewels and some pinky tones that coordinate with the card. And card number one is finished. So that's one way to use the spring flower stencil. I'm gonna show you another one, kind of an unexpected. You know what I say, if you have a leaf, make a wreath. Normally that applies to leaf stamps or leaf dies, but today I'm gonna make a wreath with a leaf stencil. So what I'm doing here is masking off using a bunch of masking tape, but I wanted one, two, and three. I wanted to isolate three of the leaves so that I could just work my way around this circle. I took a die and I traced it with a pencil so that it would be centered and would give me that nice wreath form in the middle of my panel. Now I'm taking my tried and true, never go wrong trio of distress inks that are in cool tones. I'm telling you, been using it for years. And I'll never get tired of these three colors together. Twisted Citron, Cracked Pistachio, and Mermaid Lagoon. I'm telling you, it's heavenly. Old Tim Holtz knows what he's doing. Okay, so I'm just working my way around that wreath formation, just alternating the different colors and the different leaf shapes. And it comes together lickety-split. And it's kind of an unexpected way to get a little more mileage out of the spring flowers stencil set. Now, if you wanted to, after you built the wreath, you could take the other stencil that's like blooms and you could add a few, you know, blooms to the wreath. I didn't do that. I just wanted to keep it kind of simple. Now I'm smushing the Mermaid Lagoon onto an acrylic block and flicking it on just for a couple little dreamy flicks. Not too much, just a little bit. Now I'm going to take a larger circle die and die cut a frame to frame the wreath. And I'm going to stamp this Happy Mother's Day sentiment, which is from the Mom stamp set, stamping it right in the center of the wreath. Now, this is where you could customize this card and put any different sentiment for various occasions. You could also turn this card into a shaker. I didn't add a shaker window. I'm keeping it kind of simple today. I'm just putting a little tape runner on the back of this panel and slapping it down onto a cream card base. And then to finish it off, I added a mixture of sparkling clear sequins and some little white jewels. Just a little smidge, keeping it very simple and clean for this particular Mother's Day card. I hope you enjoyed this video and it gave you some inspiration for the spring flower stencil. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.